Hello everyone, this is Marshall Gittler, Head of Investment Research here at BD Swiss, bringing our weekly Market Moves on MT4 webinar, well, with my colleague Frank Walbaum. I'm going to give you a brief rundown and then Frank will tell you how to trade the markets, or how he's trading the markets, I should say more accurately. Just before I begin, I just have to remind everyone that trading does have risks and you should trade carefully and responsibly. Right, so what are we going to do today? First, we're going to go through the positioning. Then I'm going to discuss the week's indicators. And before that, I'd like to discuss the US politics that are coming up this, because I think that's going to be an important factor in the markets. The main thing is that there's still no agreement on the CARES Act 2.0. The first initial CARES Act was the one that injected $3 trillion, I think it was, into the US economy, but that's expiring. And it's going to leave millions, tens of millions of people with no money. It's going to leave cities with no money for their public transportation, so people can't get to their jobs. It's going to leave hospitals with no money. It's a disaster. And right now, both houses of the House of Representatives and the Senate are adjourned, so they can't do anything. This is going to really hurt the US economy if they don't get their act together soon. Now, the head of the House, the majority leader in the House of Representatives, Nancy Pelosi, is calling the House back to Washington. They're on vacation now. She's calling it back to Washington to discuss not the CARES Act, but the US Post Office, because Trump is trying to sabotage the US Post Office to prevent mail-in voting by mail. He knows that the only way he can win the election is by preventing people from voting. So he knows that a lot of people won't go to vote because they're worried about the virus. They'll try to mail their votes in. So he's just really disassembling the post office. The problem is Pelosi can call the House back, but they can't do anything without the Senate. So that's going to be a big issue in the states this week. Meanwhile, the Democratic convention, the virtual convention, is this week, and they will formally enact Joe Biden as the presidential candidate, and then we'll get much more about his program he wants to do, and there may be some discussion of that and what the differences between the Democratic platform and the Republican platform would mean for the U.S. economy. Right, well, let's discuss the positioning that we've seen. First, the news from the Commitments of Traders report that comes out every Friday night. The same trends that we've been seeing for a long time. Speculators keep buying the euro and selling the dollar. Selling the dollar through buying currencies, and also through selling the DXY index. In fact, I think a lot of it this week was more in selling the DXY than in buying currencies. Seems that people are basically trimming their risk in other currencies, but they're raising their positions in the euro. On the left-hand side, we have the raw numbers, the number of contracts that the speculators are holding. In the right-hand graph, that's the speculators' net positions as a percent of open interest, as a percent of all the contracts, both long and short, that they have. You can look at the left-hand one as, for example, the number of people in the boats, in the number of people on one side of a boat. And the graph on the right you can look at that as the number of people on one side of a boat as a percent of the total people in the boat. So how far the people in the boat are tilting it over to one side or the other. We're putting out a new publication on this every week, every Monday. This has a lot of the similar graphs and explanations of it. Please take a look at that. It's a complicated subject, but I think it will reward you by letting you know what other people in the market are doing. For example, what the hedge funds are doing, what the asset managers are doing, people like that. Well, we also have a look at the risk reversals. This is an options play. I mean, it's buying a call option, selling a put option, and looking at the difference in the implied volatility between the two. If it's positive, it means that calls are more expensive. It means that people are buying insurance against upside in that pair. If the puts are more expensive, it means they're short, means they're trying to buy insurance against downside in that pair. So this really tells us how scared people are of various currency pairs moving in one direction or another. The trend seems to be people are getting more and more bullish euros. The euro dollar risk reversal moved over into positive territory recently, and it's continued to gain. It's the biggest gainer this week, as you can see from the table on the right. Otherwise, the market also cut there, became a little bit less bearish on the Kiwi and Aussie, but they're still bearish, but they're just a little bit less. That's the other top two movers there on the table. On the other hand, they became more bearish on or less positive on the Scandinavian currencies. You can see from the graph on the left that Euro Aussie and Euro Sterling are the pairs that people want to buy insurance against rising, whereas Sterling Yen and Aussie Yen are the ones that people think might have the biggest prospects of falling. So people are bullish on Yen and very skeptical about the pound is what we can and what we can discern from these figures. Finally, we've got some we single out the gold and silver data. The speculative positioning in gold and silver has been falling recently. It's very interesting. Even as the price has been soaring, the specs, the professional investors have been trimming their positions. They're not driving this rally. I couldn't really find what is driving the rally from looking at the futures data. Meanwhile, the risk reversals, though, show that people are still bullish silver. It's the bullish silver risk reversal is the highest it's been in about a year. They're a little bit less bullish gold, but still solidly bullish on gold too. Meanwhile, let's discuss moving right along the week's indicators. We had probably the major indicator for the week out already today. That was Japan's second quarter GDP. It came out a little bit worse than expected, down 7.8% quarter on quarter. The market was looking for it to be down 7.6%. Still, that's the best of the major economies. You can see from the graph on the right what people are. I've plugged the actual figures for the second quarter in with the market forecast for the third quarter and beyond. You can see that Japan has the shallowest decline. It's also expected not to rebound that much. So basically, the market expects Japan to recover more or less at the same pace as the U.S. and the Eurozone. I think that these forecasts are going to be revised very heavily. I expect the Eurozone to do better than the U.S. just because the U.S. is really undergoing so much or having so many problems with the virus. The Eurozone also, but it's breaking out again, but nowhere to the same degree that it is in the U.S. The main other indicators out this week, the main thing on Friday, we've got the purchasing managers' indices, the preliminary ones from the major economies. The manufacturing PMIs, the graph on the left, are expected to show continued movement to the right. That is continued expansion or an accelerating expansion, but at a much lower, slower pace. Whereas last month, some of them were up 6 points over the previous month. For example, Germany is only expected to be up another 3 points. So it's still up, but the pace of increase is expected to slow, which is only natural as we get back to normal and get back into expansion. The curious thing, though, is that the service sector purchasing managers' indices, the graph on the right, are not expected to do so well. Those are expected to be little changed. And that's important because it's the service sector that really was being hit by the pandemic. We'd like to see more those continue to rise. But several of them have They've moved into expansionary territory, as you can see. It's just expected to stabilize. So what we're the message we're getting from the PMIs, or that we're expected to get from the PMIs, is going to be a slowdown in the pace of recovery. Continued expansion, but just a slowdown in the pace. That's also the message that we're expected to get from the Empire and Philly Fed surveys out this week. Empire out this today, Philly Fed, I think it's Thursday or Friday. Still, those are expected to also be in expansionary territory, but not as much, just down a little bit. The other big indicators from the US are the housing starts and building permits. This is housing is a bright spot for the US economy. It's bouncing back rapidly. In fact, it's a bright spot globally. What we're seeing everywhere is people are finding that they can work from home. This means they don't have to live in the crowded city in a tiny little two-bedroom flat. They can move into a house where they have a proper office to work from home from, and they have a garden, and they have a driveway, and they can park their car, et cetera, et cetera. So all over the world, we're seeing people moving out of houses, moving out of cities and into the suburbs. This has caused, by the way, a surge in lumber futures, which have risen to a record high. In fact, that's the graph on the left. The graph on the right shows that lumber futures this year have even outpaced gold and silver. You thought silver was soaring. Lumber is doing even better. Now we're going to get more news on that later today when the National Association of Home Builders releases its market index. And there's been an accident with this. They accidentally released the data on their website on Friday. But I don't think anyone's noticed this. And it's better than the forecast. The forecast is to go up to 74 from 72, but the actual figure is 78. Are tying the record high. I think when Wall Street opens and this figure is formally released or all the news agencies realize it's come out, I think home builders index and anything in the construction industry is going to do really, really well. And you can get in on this now during European time by trading with us and with us on this. So please talk to your advisor about this. I think this is really a great opportunity. I may have missed a story, but I didn't find any stories about it. Bloomberg certainly doesn't have a story, although they did have the data. The machine that downloads the data automatically downloaded it, but no people noticed it. And I don't think any other news agencies have noticed it either. I did a Google search, didn't find anything. This is the closest you'll get to legal inside information in your career. Finally, we have the UK inflation data coming out this week. UK inflation is expected to slow both on a core level and headline level. I think this is likely to reinforce the idea that some people have that the Bank of England's next move is going to be easing, that they're going to ease later on this year. I think this could prove to be negative for the pound. And with that, I'm going to switch over to my colleague, Frank, who will tell you how he's going to trade these.
Yeah, hi. Thanks, Marshall. And let's get going and have a look what's working out in the market. S&P 500 and interesting information we received regarding the Home Builders Association as well. Home Depot is a company we could have a look at later on in the day, potentially. Home Depot, the construction market in the US, that's something we might or should take a look at. Let me have a look. I've opened it here. Too many charts on HD. This is not Harley Davidson, the great motorcycle company. It's Home Depot. They have lost a bit of momentum, technically a slight bit. We could see that this company is also increasing in value as well, potentially because if you're buying a second-hand home as well, the first thing you might want to do is repair and renovate stuff as well, leading to more demand from Home Depot. I haven't had a look as of recently on how they performed, but obviously, as we can see, the stock price from them also gradually moving higher, actually rather moving higher in line with the Nasdaq index looks kind of similar, this chart. So to me, overbought already in this high up territory, but something you might express your interest in. So keep an eye on this throughout the US session later when this one comes to life. Apart from this, stock markets being well bid again, and the precious metals also moving higher as well. Gold here, this is the short-term chart, we can see starting to break away as well. And this is something interesting. Let's buy two, not 20. Let's buy two contracts as well. I think we could place a fairly small stop loss as well. The market looks pretty much moving and grinding higher again. Similarly, also as well regarding the precious metals, precious metals, sorry, is a Bitcoin, the crypto world as well, moving to the upside. But a gold potentially could strengthen further. The question remains the same: will we get inflationary environment rather soon? My answer could be that inflation would pick up steam, and that also alongside precious metals could add up in value as well, simply because so far interest rates are being low, there's no big demand as well in interest as well, and hence obviously precious metals are one potentially moving forward. Not only gold, also silver could regain momentum as well, though silver obviously is a bit of the tricky option as well. Why that? Simply the volatility is extremely high, and it's also rather an industrial metal. But if we're looking at it from the historical positioning here, we could see that this upward train here could gain momentum. Our long order, or not our long order, our long buy stop has been triggered last week, and our option here that the market, not our option, sorry, that the market moves to the upside looks pretty good, and that in this case really offering us a certain momentum higher. So some positioning now in silver, and as of gold as well, I ordered, or have added another buy opportunity here, or buy order as well, and this one has been kind of directly a live order in the market, looking good, upside momentum seemingly the case. If the market moves a bit lower initially first, we'll have to reassess here, but in general I would think that this makes perfect sense. Ethereum, Bitcoin, obviously those are also moving to the upside. Not quite too late to enter here, but of course, since we are living in modern age, we're talking about electronic cars, we should also potentially think further on electronic currencies, and Ethereum is also one way moving forward. This could see the market exploding higher. The main breakout point was the 195 area, or say 200 level. Now we are trading at multiples already to the upside here. We are trading at 340. This can't be manipulated, right, guys? That's something important I have to add here as well. We have no central bank intervention. This is a limited asset seemingly, and also with more inflationary measures, potentially we could see also that an interesting option here could Ethereum very well be. As we have traded also in the past at high levels at around 1,000 or 1,100 already, I would say that there is still a doubling in value, very much potential, and that the market could really gain certain momentum similarly to Bitcoin as well. As we can see as well, Bitcoin is trading at a major resistance area. We could call it a double top if we compare the pricing range here. But it looks like so far, that's from the longer term, from the monthly perspective, that the market really is not really stopping here, but instead moving higher as well once the crisis starts to, well, unfold, maybe deepen on one hand, or maybe also worsened somehow. We could see that some sort of momentum could be seen here in the crypto world, and Bitcoin and Ethereum are definitely the two moving forward, which I'm checking on how to get further momentum here and potentially also get in with a nice positioning here. We can see triangle formation for the charting perspective, guys, of us here. A resistance area here, the market's pushing higher, the breakout seems valid and rather coming. The same option also is what we could see here in Ethereum. We have the similar opportunity as well here, looking at it from this slide a different perspective here, because the breakout has been already happening here. You can see sideways triangle formation here. The market grinds higher and now, boom, the breakout's happening. Retest so far. Remember as well, obviously here, this one is going to be traded also over the weekend. So definitely here some trading fun as well to be seen. And this could really last for some further uptrend momentum here, guiding the markets to trade higher as well and making it interesting here for some sort of insights here. If you're looking at Ethereum, I said I have no real idea where the market initially would head to. Next targets could be the 400 level. Obviously, expect quite some volatility as well. 530, that's at least from my charting perspective here. What I would see, those lines are the ones that guiding me potentially need to dig out some further short-term charts and putting in some resistance and support areas. Yet we can see also what seemingly is key and what my lines in the center showing me, and that's definitely here the monthly resistance 2 and 3 are pointing to the 400 level, which seemingly is still quite a way and offering us some sort of momentum to the upside. Apart from this, right now I have to say I'm a bit on the quiet side here. The markets seem a bit muted. The typical Monday, the Japanese yen indeed shows a bit of market movement here. The market resists or trading at resistance area in terms of the dollar Japanese yen. Remember as well, the US dollar starts continues to get a bit weakening or gets a bit weaker for now as well. Alongside, we can see that the JP is taking up a bit of momentum here. This could point to falling prices here. We could see that the market is really starting to hop to the downside here and starting to offer us some sort of momentum, a lower as well. And in this case here, we might see a continuation of the market moves here to follow through. So dollar yen lower confirmation. We also get from the from other currencies here, from the pound, which is indeed weakening a bit as well against the JP, and also regarding the euro also shows a bit of a weakening momentum here. This could be a bit of a risk averse market movement. That's the overall idea, obviously, if we especially talking about the precious metals here. But the question remains rather the same, that investors like are still focused on one hand on the stock markets. We can see that the Dow Jones also still on a triangle higher, pushing, grinding higher as well. As said, this could be an interesting area here to purchase the market as well and offset some of the losses here, waiting for the markets to put all steam here ahead towards the resistance area, towards the main resistance area. That's at least one thing I would see here in the Dow Jones. On the other hand as well, we'll have to go back now, we can see also movement in the S&P 500. So it's not a one-way train here. S&P 500 starting to move a bit to the upside here. I'll assess this in the US session here later. I might add a bit of an order here as well. Last week we closed rather in a bullish manner here. The market seemingly is moving to the upside. I don't see anything at the moment, unfortunately, but again, the situation could change immediately, especially looking at it from the political landscape in the US. We still have the big issuing between the Democrats and the Republicans. Election year coming through. No side wants to give the other chance an opportunity to kind of come out of this situation stronger. And I have the feeling the more the story goes on, that Trump is making up with his current politics, is making up some ground as well, and leading towards a potential re-election, where everyone again will cry in the end, will say what the nonsense, what the heck is going on. But in the end, I have to say, look, it's America. It's the American people who vote for it. Everyone able and potentially at least able to own guns legally, they have to do what they think themselves. But in any case, a long political story here. From my side, shorter, I could believe that this is happening further and that in this case as well, the stock markets could be obviously affected. Back to the US dollar, we can see some movement as well to the weaker side here. Still, I believe as well, medium term, we could also see some strengthening, especially after this sideways pattern here, strengthening in the US dollar. So far, it's been a sideways move. So the same story as we talked about it more or less last week. The market, though, could weaken further here as long as we stay within this sideways trend here. We might get a bit of an overshoot here towards the 119 area again, but still, I believe that that what we can see here so far is not technically not quite a bullish movement. It's just a sideways pattern. And should the market really act to it accordingly, we might see a bit of a weakening potential here to come. Yet, I have to admit as well, looking at it from the charting perspective only, I would say that this looks like bullish for the euro. This could, of course, be the continuation we could see here right now. We might see that this was everything here to come in terms of sideways price action. Remember, we have the overbought territory here in the RSI indicator. The market trend sideways points towards higher pricing here. But instead, usually what we can see is that, especially also from the daily chart, it's pretty clear here, obvious stuff, market trends higher. And then with this pricey side, or with this sideways price action here, also comes a reducing indicator here in terms of the RSI indicator, pointing towards reducing this RSI pattern towards the mid 50 level, where then new momentum could be built up. What we can see only in the weekly chart, and that's kind of an interesting difference here, at least for me, looking at the RSI indicator for quite some time here, we can see the curve only slightly flattening here, but on the daily chart it's been weakening already a fair bit. Long story for you, it means the market is still in the steady uptrend, a bullish mentality also from the monthly charting perspective. And God knows where the market goes. Again, I'll repeat myself here. I would not be wondering if the market really tanks, if the US dollar is coming back to life. A bit of positive news potentially only needed for some correction lower before the remaining uptrend could be seen further. But this really kind of depends on the situation here as well. And looking at the pound here, we've seen somehow positive news this morning in the pound strengthening also a bit against the US dollar here. Nothing major as well, still standing a bit weaker to my extent here, comparing the pound with the euro, but both of them staying so far on a sideways path here, looking good to break higher. But if we compare it with this situation here and with potentially also COVID-19 case count growing, further lockdowns potentially, you know, the entire situation moving on further, we might see that this trend really changes dramatically, quickly at least, as we've seen it when COVID-19 hit the markets fully and everyone was in turmoil getting rid of their stock portfolio and leading the markets to tumble a lot. So that's what I can observe here. Euro pound, hence no change in direction, rather slightly bullish. Again, as we had it last week, we got stopped out, unfortunately, in our trade here. The market did not trend lower as we expected it, but in the end really went higher. And that's now the power of the trend line. Before we saw it like this, and right now we could argue that the trend line still is steady to the upside here. And we should wait a bit, I think. Usually what we see is that Monday offers us some retracements lower, and then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, the market trends higher. We have a resistance area here at 91.40. Not really sure if I want to trade the market accordingly, but this might be something moving forward tomorrow onwards. You'll find details if we enter this position here in our Telegram group. Check with your account manager as well what's needed. We made it obviously for your safety as well, that you need to potentially add a bit of funds as well in order to play safe here. If you're trading with a very small account, my trades usually are a bit of a longer term trades, and longer term trades equal wider stop losses. So in order to trade even a small position, you might need a bit of a safety buffer in order to trade. Hence, we added this safety net here for you guys. But that's it. Check it out. So far, that's honestly speaking also the only situation I would see where I would like to add up trades here for now. And to recap, I think we are in good shape with our silver markets position here. The market started with a bit of a weakening potential, kind of typical Asian session markets, tanks a bit here. And right now, with the start of the European session, we see some rebound. Also, the four-hour chart here looks pretty good, looks like a bullish chart here for our candlestick experts. It's a railroad tracks, you could call it, one way down, one way up, boom, in a bigger mentality here, moving higher up, confirming the uptrend. So this looks good. Then a bit of a gold play as well, not cold play, which is a great band by the way, but the gold play in this case here, markets trending higher. We already kind of at entry so far with this position, and if we can see that this retracement, as I would call it, we have a bigger blue candles than red candles, equaling to bigger bullish movements here, comparing it to bearish movements, bullish sideways, bullish, and then sideways long trend, and now new week, the market could gain momentum. It's looking good, actually, despite this huge, messy negative momentum candle, but the markets are trading like this currently, right? So we have a move away from actual numbers. We have a move away from facts, from economic output figures and such. We have a market-driven trades caused by, how you call it, maybe by market moves, by money flows, I would rather say. And once the flow starts, the market really continued big time. Volatility increased a lot. The silver vol was trading, or we are trading at 70% vol in silver recently, making it a bit more dangerous potentially to trade. But right after came a sudden stoppage point here, and the market right now starts trending higher. And that's what I would expect to last potentially. As some of us here at BD Swiss as well, we were some guys were saying, hey, look, the football match for the football fans last week, Bayern Munich made it nicely. My supported team as well here, being from Northern Germany, but we made it nicely in the Champions League as well. 8 goals over a very interesting football club here. In any case, also volatility in football, you could maybe see also is grinding up or picking up momentum. I'm not sure if you could do this this conclusion, or, but in any case, the markets tense and trend really kind of into interesting waters right now. So be careful how you trade them. Some sort of smaller position at the beginning of your trading career rather makes sense, I would say, because the markets can be quite dangerous, quite deadly, unless you have such a big account as well as I'm trading it here. Then you're having a bit of ease of mind, I would say. Looking at it in the end towards the German index here, the German DAX index starting a bit weaker. Could be a sign, it could be a leading towards a weakening momentum. With the guys I talk, with the professionals I talk to, as most of them, the big players are not in any of their index plays as well. Some, of course, have picked up some stocks, but obviously the big trend, the big uptrend, they all more or less missed here, the uptrend which has been lasting for so long. This could be going on still for quite some time as well. I would play so far and ask so far the markets to trend towards a major resistance, as I would call it here, as of the recent all-time highs, more or less. With the German DAX, it's also kind of at the 13,800 level here. This could be the case, could happen as well. But still, guys, I still believe that there might be some sort of a rolling over in the markets and some sort of correction, at least when we see a shift from tech values, from tech growth stocks towards value stocks as well. When the investment world changes, when the election is due, uncertainty still is picking up momentum towards November. We can see that with general volatility also staying at elevated levels. This can be confirmed as well here, and this can be confirmed if we're looking at the volatility index here. The VIX still has moved lower, definitely towards the 22 area, but easygoing levels are rather at 14, 15, say, and not at this at this high level. Plus, why I'm still seeing lots of uncertainty. If you're looking at the bank index here, bank stocks, U.S. bank stocks as well, they're still trading way below their all-time highs here. And once bank stocks, or when, until, that's the correct wording, until bank stocks pick up in value as well, you can usually say that the real players in the markets are still having doubt as well, if the banks are still putting aside billions of dollars in order to kind of for their fallouts in debt as well. That really tells the story as well. There's much more to come in the economy as well. We see obviously airplane travel is picking up momentum. Further lockdowns are still bad issues as well. Me being German, I can't easily travel back to my home country of choice, Singapore as well. You know, like you can't enter the country. I could, but it's going to be an expensive endeavor as well, as I have to pay myself for the 14 days quarantine in a 5-star hotel, as they do it over there. Same applies for Thailand. If you're even able to enter, you also have to do quarantine. Case count picking up in Spain and Italy, hence everyone in trouble. Everyone is thinking on the overall situation. Fear is reigning the markets as well, I think, and that's maybe also one reason, as some say, that the only thing we can control in our lives, potentially, as it feels like, are the stock markets. And this could be one reason why the stock markets are still showing as much momentum as they do. So let's take it a bit with caution as well. German DAX, to sum it up, looks a bit weaker here. We might see the markets really starting on a negative tone here for now. As we see, we had a higher open, but the market is moving a bit lower. Risk off paired, in a way, some sort of risk off in terms of dollar Japanese yen. paired with some further gains in the precious metal space. Gold, a buy, that's definitely something interesting for me at least. Silver buy is still on, slightly in positive territory here, and the rest of the currencies here, I'm checking on whatever works. I haven't found anything interesting so far for me right now. Harry, pound Aussie moving back up. Yeah, that's a bit of a situation here. Right now, we have a trade to the upside. Indeed, thanks. I nearly forgot about this. The market is trending slightly higher. Well, should see it and observe it from the weekly perspective, though. The market was in a bullish trend here. Technically, we are still in a bullish trend since this bullish candle has not been threatened to the downside. Instead, we are still trading way above the 50% retracement, I would at least say, right? So we haven't retraced, say, 50% of this candle, kind of lower. The market looks to me still breaking higher. It turns a bit riskier as we have retraced a fair bit to the downside, but I would say still, despite the Friday candle here, Friday pin bar here, we entered on Friday, not the best day to enter in such a long-term trade. But if the uptrend or the uptake really keeps steadying here as it does currently, we could see that the market really lasts like this and really showing us momentum. So I wouldn't worry about it so much. I would still keep and stay in, as I do definitely, and hence also looking for a rising prices now. So guys, happy trading as always. That's all from my side here. Talk to you later. Bye bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.